what is wrong with the approach of taking a course either in high school or in college, basic micro? Why is that not adequate?
I don't think it's sexy to take these courses to begin with, and I don't think that what excites us covering Wall Street necessarily excites the public, because they don't get it. For me, covering Wall Street since about 20 years, this is very much about emotions. It's about making money, losing money, you know, it's seeking opportunity, taking risks. That's exciting to me. You know, Facebook, Google, they all come into existence. But this level of excitement, to transport it in the public, I think that is key. And that is what We the Economy is all about. It's basically showing that there is a huge bridge between what happens on Main Street and on Wall Street. We are all connected to Wall Street. By the end of the day, if we drive a car, if we sit in a building, if we work for public companies, they're all funded by Wall Street.
But you, again, had to make a decision about schools. I mean, there's this gulf when you report for your home market in Germany. They think of economics in a completely different way. So you've got two challenges, and that's what I'm confused about. Not only do you have to get people to care about economics, you've got to teach them that there's a huge debate. I would actually disagree. I think it's much less than 85% that economists agree on. I think maybe we're at like 50%. How do you teach the debate?
Well, I think you have to break it down to very basic levels. And I think Cavenomics is a great example for that. Look, it's fun. You get to laugh. But if you get people to laugh, you get them to listen. And I think we're all in the news business.
But let me jump in on, I want to jump in on Cavenomics, because I watched that. And there is a huge debate that's ignored by Cavenomics, which is anthropologists look at economics and they say there's no such thing as this caveman market. It didn't work that way. There weren't market economies in primitive societies. And that's an important distinction.
Well, I think when you look at Cavenomics, I think that, you know, most people who watch Cavenomics don't automatically think that there were like cave markets where this was happening. I think most people will look at Cavenomics and realize we're using this as a platform to explain a bigger story, which is about here's how things started to happen. People started to trade things. They started to create businesses. Off of that, they created a real economic system. So I think that we're not saying that ultimately people, you know, Glug and Ugg were like in caves, like, you know, thumping their chests and trading these things. I think most people will watch this and realize we're using it as much more of a metaphor.
Yeah, the idea of how things came out, the motivations for people. I want to ask you, is Janet Yellen making macroeconomics more understandable to people when she visits factories and talks about the workers that she meets there?
I would think so, yes. But by the end of the day, the question really is, does the worker actually understand how he's connected to all of this? Funding a public company, you know, basically getting them to grow, or through QE, for example, getting companies back on track. And if they grow, they employ people, and that goes down to the job. And I think for us, we have to take the bottom-up approach, not the top-down approach. Mm. It's always the expert at the top telling everybody, well, this is going to happen and this is what you have to get. You have to change the opinion. How does the bottom-up view us, actually? How do we get them to listen to us?
I think that you're dealing on this show with a slightly hostile audience. The people who watch are thinking, I don't want my kids watching videos. I want my kids to go to college, and I want them to read Greg Mankiw's textbook, and that's how I want it to happen.
Yeah.
Sell this not to us, but to them. Why is this important to them?
Well, here's the biggest thing. I think, in reality, as you were saying, why can't we take a micro class in high school? Most people don't take a microeconomics class in high school. That's a fact. I didn't have one, and most people I know who are in high school don't have one. I think you have to begin a conversation somewhere. And for me, this is a great way to open up the doorway to a much larger conversation about what happens in our society and how we're all affected.
Where do they go next? What's the textbook? What's the website they read when they like the movie and they think, all right, now there's something I'm going to learn?
Well, I think the next step is to actually realize that you're more involved with all of this than you actually think. And I think that's, you know, like Morgan said, it's a great door opener for everybody to participate. And it's empowering for everybody. You're all part of it.
Mm-hmm. And there are multiple books and things that are listed. If you go to wetheeconomy.com, where we point you towards. Once you watch one film, here you go. We're going to give you a plethora of opportunities.